Since passwords have problems, and we said that's only one of the ways in which you can do authentication, let's look at some of the other ways in which authentication can be done. So the other one, second one, was something you have. So a token or a smart card or something like that. Obviously, if it's something you have, then you must have it on them. If you don't have your token or your smart card or your smartphone, if that's being used as the something you have, you can't obviously access the system. And people sometimes forget these things and don't have them on them when they need to access, especially banks, when they give you these tokens or send you some sort of a code through them. If you don't have that with you, you're not going to be able to access your account. So not having them would cause a problem. So you do have to have them. That's one of the requirements when you use this method. So obviously it is something that you must have. It should be able to talk to the system, or the human has to enter the PIN or whatever code that is sent to them. But if it's a smart card, the smart card has to talk to the system, which requires you have to have a reader, for example. You should be able to swipe the smart card and it should be able to communicate. So that adds the hardware requirement, which increases cost. Even if you have it at the other end, they should have a reader. If they don't have it, then you can't use it with that system. How is authentication implemented with the something you have? If you have a smart card, we're just talking about, that can talk to the system, then there could be some sort of a challenge response kind of a thing. So the system can say, if you really belong to the user that is being claimed, or claim is made being made about the identity of a certain user, then that user's smart card has a certain secret, use that secret to sort of maybe respond to my challenge, encrypt it or something like that, or do something to this challenge. The response should demonstrate that the secret that is stored in this smart card is the one that is used to generate the response. So sometimes if you have some processing in the smart card can do this sort of computation, generate a response that could be sent. So on this pin and chip kind of cards, the chip can do this kind of work, and that's how this would be implemented. The problem with this is that there is added cost, and of course, sometimes there could be misplaced trust in these kind of tokens or cards that we're talking about for something you have. There's, of course, the very well-known case of the RSA breach, where the master key was compromised. And as a result of that, all the secure ID tokens that RSA Stronger Authentication relied on, you couldn't count on doing correct authentication using those. And so there's added cost we are talking about, but there's also vulnerabilities or attacks that can limit the strength that authentication, the stronger authentication that these kind of tokens provide. So something you have, you don't need to remember those complex passwords you're talking about, but we need to be aware of the fact that they have their own set of problems.